my response video to a few videos, and I think, but anyway, it's just kind of discouraging. Really dumb videos out there. Really, really, really dumb. It's just tedious as hell. Somebody left some snarky comment. I should just do that comment, you know, like, somehow this shouldn't be irritating and frustrating to have to explain just basic things. Like, it's like you're going to build the Hoover Dam and you show up with all these people and you find out they don't even know what a shovel is. And you're like, oh, you mean I have to explain shovels to these guys? I mean, we got a whole damned engineer and build, and we haven't got to shovel yet. It's that kind of thing. So anyway, he calls himself Church Caller. Again, I don't know whether these people represent anything. I mean, does this idiot attitude represent anybody? Does it represent any mass of people who have a stumbling block, like who can't figure out that if they could cure a disease, all they had to do was go, don't have children. I mean, that was the extent of their effort, and they could cure malaria. That, wow, that really didn't take much effort. I mean, that they wouldn't do it. For what? For what reason would they say they don't think it's a good idea? They wouldn't express the opinion, I don't think it's a good idea. I think it's wrong. Whoa, don't dare say that. How outrageous. You'll wear yourself out telling other people you think something they're doing is wrong. I don't know, just the silliest arguments. Like somehow, if it doesn't affect you, it doesn't happen. It's not happening. Like if you were in the Hunger Games, right? Hunger Games, stupidest movie ever made, pretty much. And you found a button and all you had to do was go, all you had to do was like recite two sentences, you know. I think having children is immoral and unethical and indecent and nasty and selfish and stupid. Please don't do it. And all you do is hit that button, and then the Hunger Games never happen again. Yeah, I mean, what? You wouldn't do it. Because you're too selfish. It's too much work. I had to think about it. I don't want to think about anything else going on in the world. It just doesn't make any sense at all. I mean, if you care about animals, and you care about people, and being in bad circumstances, and you just say, don't do anything about it, just get yourself out. All right, but fuck the rest of them. It's like you're a slave or you're in a prisoner of war camp and you escape. Fuck the rest of the prisoners. Fuck them. You know, it's just about you. Yeah. Well, sorry. You know, they're not going to make a movie about the great asshole. You know, it's you got to do better than that. Are you going to just be labeled as a person who sucks? So anyway, Herwin just made this whole little whiny bit video about how it's just too much of a burden to concern yourself with anybody in the future. And, you know, if you do, you can only do it through some religious notion. You must be some sort of religious person to identify with the other victims. If you think the other people in the concentration camp are just like you, you're a religious nut. Yeah, and if you think all the people in future wars in concentration camps are just like you, oh, that's really wacky religion. So anyway, I'll just deal with one point he made. You know, he attempted to turn Benatar's asymmetry upside down and say it's some sort of selfish statement. You know, that all you have to do is cure your problem and the problem is solved. Because somehow you fix the asymmetry of life itself by unasymmetrying your own existence. Like, that makes any sense. The title of his book is Better Never to Have Been. Yeah, so you fix the have-been problem by killing yourself. That somehow the book wouldn't be written the next day and the same problem still exists. Yeah, I mean, it's just too... This is too insensical. I mean, he's just... Whatever game he's playing, whatever bullshit this is, it is just... You know, it is the lowest kind of human crap that pulls this crap. You know, that just... plays this, like I say, I could just play his old videos where he's talking about all life is silly, stupid desires, mindless compulsions. He every once in a while, he did even contrive some notion of some empathy for animals. All of that's gone now. He just, and you're just saying, well, if somebody can swing, if their philosophical views can swing this widely in a matter of a few months, why are they making videos? Like they're going to make some kind of reasonable contribution. You know, this is just another video to be deleted, another opinion that he'll retract. So just add confusion, just add nonsense. Why? Because you snorted some of the gas out of Great Tex's ass, and this is the effect it had on your brain? Ugh, you're pitiful. Anyway, enough of this asshole. Ugh, this is just disgusting. It's just too silly. Don't fix a problem. Just worry about yourself. I mean, that kind of attitude is just amazing to me. Just absolutely amazing. You don't stop the better never to have been problem yourself. And to not fix it for the other victims is just so selfish, so disgustingly selfish. Like I said, it's just nothing to admire there. Anyway, these two people are sort of it. This was a good video. Responding to ignorant crap readers say. So this was kind of a good video. Yeah. It's nice to see a couple on YouTube. You don't get too much of that. So, let's see. Conference report. Yeah, this one was won by... what's his name? I'll wait for his name to show up, and then I'll tell you whose his name is. And my browser's running a little slow here. It's really fucked up, apparently. Anyway, looks like it's got like a skunk hat on or something. Light does interesting things. It did that in my video too. But anyway, all right. So it's response to the conference report. Basically, it's Meester Pool or whatever. And so he goes through this video, blah 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 blah, just making rationalizations for coming way short of again fixing the problem. Built into the video is some notion that somehow animals are doing just fine in nature. That's just, living out your biological existence as a crocodile is somehow a worthwhile ambition, or living out your existence as a biology-controlled grazing machine. Oh yeah, that's just great. Just no acknowledgement of the fundamental fail on so many levels. Just this whole somehow you have to make concessions to something. And yeah, that's fine. Go ahead and tell somebody. People, like I said, they can go ahead and they don't even have to be vegetarian to advocate for vegetarian ethics and to just acknowledge the truth that they have been programmed to suck, that their behavior sucks, and that's just the way it is. And so you even mentioned, hunting. If you go hunting once a year as a ritualistic fun time, why don't you just call it what it is? If you've been psychotically and are sadistically programmed to somehow derive pleasure in hunting down, terrifying, and killing little sentient creatures for your ego gratification, call it what it is. You want to placate it, fine. I'm not going to argue that this is, in the total mass, that this is the hugest substance of the suffering. Nature itself is the biggest murderer and horror imposer. But why romanticize? Why sit there and placate the existence of the thing? This is just stupid, if you raise your own animal and pet it and love it and then, stab it in the back someday and eat it, I'm going to eat a friend of mine. Yeah, that's really classy. I'm going to raise it so I can slaughter it and then sit there on a dinner table and eat it. And that'll demonstrate how I see you, how I somehow have respected it. Yeah, sorry. No fucking sale. When people start eating their dogs and cats, I'll start paying some attention to this bullshit. Go to your local farmer who's completely unregulated and is probably a sadistic whack job. Yeah, that's so much better. Whatever. So just fail as a... Why not just say what it is, okay? It's a stupid, silly, traditional eating habit, and you ought to just get the fuck over it. So anyway, so then the other asshole is that stupid Noel Plum guy, so maybe we'll play some of his video. But I don't have much of a hope that there's going to be anything I can do anything with, because he doesn't say anything. He's one of these personalities on the internet. You know, all this movement and all this, yeah, I'm trying to be the British amazing fucktard or something. Yeah, well, he's the amazing twat-tard. So anyway, let's play a little hunk of this.
He claimed that you make, so what, I'm promoting meat-eating now as the better of the alternatives, so what I need to do is to...
Yeah, whatever. So yeah, I'm promoting meat-eating, okay, so this is like not a video to be taken seriously, please. Right, it's, you know, it's this loaded, sensitive subject, you know, that people who care... People who are sensitive to the suffering of these other creatures, you're effectively talking about a war. You're effectively talking about war victims. You're effectively talking about torture. These are real words, asshole. These are real concepts that are part of this ethic, and you're just mocking it. So, like, some asshole like you shows up during the slave debates or the civil rights movement with your little jerky, herky, jerky, you know, speciest rhetoric, and you're somehow going to make a valuable contribution in a passionate battle about civil rights. You know, and you're just going to be an asshole. Oh yeah, go ahead. I'm for full meat diets, even though we have a resource problem that's catastrophic on planet Earth. All right, even migrating 1 billion people, just 1 billion of them, onto a vegetarian diet could possibly gain us 10 years of energy. No, I'm not going to say anything rational and sensible. I'm just going to be an asshole on the fucking internet, and you'll get rewarded for it. And that's really disgusting. You suck. Yeah, that's what you do. You suck. Do. Maybe I gotta reload this. Might as well. YouTube sucks. Firefox semi sucks. At least it's not crashing. I get used to. Oh, look at that. He's got a video clip in the fucking video. Oh, the advertisements. Gotta make your money, right? Twat-tard. Twat-tard. Oh, gotta have your intro. Yeah, that's very important.
Now, what possible reason could that be if it wasn't the fact that meat just tastes so good?
All right, yes. So much better than Twinkies and potato chips and chocolate bars and whatever, sandwiches, right? I can give you a list of 5 million sandwiches. Lots of cans of great soups. I could get, you know, this is just so stupid. And so that's the only standard, though, for an ethical conversation, is how does it affect me? How does it taste? You know? Yeah, I mean, you know what? Slavery feels really good, because you don't have to do any work. The slaves do it, right? And civil injustice feels so good, because, yeah, you get out of all the burdens and you impose them on those people, or those people over there. Yeah, that works for me. That's so cool. So that's really logical. And we know that taste isn't some subjective conditioned thing. No, not at all. It's not something up to, like we actually as a human race have some control over what kind of silly, stupid tastes we have. You know, you're born a Mets fan, that's for sure. You're born one. Fucking idiot. Turd. Sloppy diarrhea.
Her step along the line for her was to stop eating beef. She was still eating chicken, but not eating beef. So I proposed to her that she would actually be better doing it the other way around, because obviously there's a lot more meat on a single bovine, so that, you know, for the sake of one death there, she's in actual fact...
Yeah, okay, so, yeah, let's talk about house slaves versus field slaves. Yeah, that's a great argument to have. And, yeah, there's the truth is that if you can put all of the meat on one sentient creature, like one giant guy, gigantic, like Whalosaurus or something, like some 7 million ton creature, right? And you could force feed it and torture that to get your little meat carvings off of it, so you could cut your little bit off. Yeah, that would make it all so much better, so much more defensible. And in practical fact, it's true. I mean, it's less consciousnesses per pound, but it's also more resources wasted in other ways. And I guess I would also argue that a mammal brain isn't exactly a chicken brain, but who cares? I mean, it's a stupid rationalization for bad behavior. I mean, that's all you're doing. You're just trying to explain why I was only a little bit drunk and driving.
I'm sure if you look at the average cow in the field, I have them, they live out behind me. If they could articulate how they feel about things, I get the feeling that they probably don't...
Oh, whatever. That's really rational. You get the feeling. Yeah, I looked in their eyes. Yeah, you read their little minds, did you?
Really particularly want to die. They'd sooner rather carry on living.
Yeah, whatever. So that's your projection, that they see purpose in spending the whole day chewing grass. That if they could be enlightened with intelligence, that they would find nothing wrong with their existence. Like if I was to be a great white shark, and then all of a sudden I was bestowed with knowledge of my existence and what it meant and the consequences, that I wouldn't find it at all disturbing that I'm just this menace. You know, that I'm a horror. Oh, fuck you.
Because I kind of get the idea with chickens. They're so fucking stupid.
Yeah, right. Compared to British twats. Yeah, I think they've got nothing on you in the stupid, dumbass, fuckwit department. You chicken-necked fuckwit.
And it wasn't just some mad dream I had at some stage. But yes, it's true, Mike the Chicken did exist. He did live for 18 months with his owner prodding bits of food down his neck. This is what Wikipedia says. It says this is a good example of central motor generators enabling basic homeostatic functions to be carried out in the absence of the cerebral cortex.
Yeah, whatever. So you think that's actual biology. That's the truth. A chicken lived without its head. So you're saying that its heartbeat was regulated not by any brainstem function. I tend to doubt that one. Whatever. Well, who cares? So, you know, if I can make your limbs move, that means you're alive. You know, so if somebody's in the hospital and their brain dead, but you can make their eyes twitch or you can make something twitch, somehow they're not brain dead. Whatever, fuckwit.
What I say about it is, with relation to chickens, you've got to question the value of any animal whose entire head has almost achieved vestigial.
Well, right, and if they could do the same thing, right? You're talking about just regulating a heartbeat, okay, and, you know, cauterizing, whatever, keeping the blood pressure maintained for the rest of the organs. So if they do it with humans someday, then we've proven humans have a vestigial brain. So if they keep a human alive without a head, if they keep a human body alive, which they probably have done, who the hell knows, by just putting a pacemaker in and, you know, a few other modifications, that's good enough. We've proven vestigial brain. I mean, you're just such an insulting... You're so insulting to logic and reason and anything decent. You just fucking suck. You suck.
Bred into forms. We've all seen these chickens, I would hope, these ones that they grow. The muscles are growing, the body's growing faster than the joints can take, and some of them, the joints collapse when they're young, which is a little bit nasty, really.
Oh, it's a real little bit nasty, really, but who cares, because it's food. It tastes good. Let's see what else you got to say after nasty.
Not to mention the really nasty stuff, like the way they create things like pate de foie gras and really odious stuff like that. And some people just eat fish because of that, don't they? Because you haven't got the chemicals put in, you haven't got the animal husbandry issues, etc.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, nature is such a much better husband. Yeah, nature really cares about the little fishies. Oh, man. Pathetic. Pathetic.
This is the point. It would make a difference for me, I think, if I had those ethical problems. I'd be interested for vegetarians. Would that swing the balance for vegetarians?
Let's see this
Kinstein scenario, where you've got this large, throbbing, gristly piece of meat, and I'm not talking about my cock here.
You certainly aren't.
That's growing away.
Yeah, you certainly aren't. I mean, your wife is obviously a twatitarian. No meat allowed, just twat.
Hey there, without an animal attached. It sounds a bit grisly. I would be happy to eat it. I would have no qualms. And I would think on the ethical side of it, that does that. This is the point. It would make...
Well, duh. Oh, yeah, so it's non-feeling meat. Yeah, you want to go eat something that's manufactured. A body with no sentience involved, or even if you want to raise animals without brain function, you know, without conscious brain function, fine, go eat all the zombie beef and meat and shit you want to, but it's going to be really fucking expensive, so this is sort of an irrelevant conversation. And again, why are you doing it anyway? Why are you maintaining a silly ritual? It's a silly fucking ritual. Why maintain it? Why keep it in existence? Why not just migrate the human race off of this bad diet?
The difference for me, I think, if I had those ethical problems, I'd be interested for vegetarians. Would that swing the balance for vegetarians?
Yeah, you want to eat your own shit, it's okay with me. Okay, as long as it can't say, help me, help me, help me. I mean, geez, fucking, this is so stupid. You know, I mean, really, yeah, go farm, you could go all the way, right? I mean, if you're going to bother, you might as well go ahead and farm yourself some human flesh to chew on.
Or wouldn't it? Personally, I don't really have a problem with eating meat. I like to see animals kept in good conditions. There are certain things, the veal crates I objected to.
Yeah, whatever. So you're going to tell us what's good slavery practice. Yeah, be a good slave. I'm a good master, that's all you're talking like. I treat my slaves well. Fuck you.
Transporting cattle across to other countries in the veal crates from the UK to be kept in darkness to keep the meat white, that's a nasty thing to do. I think forcing food to let down the throat...
Yeah, well, whatever, it's not going to stop you from doing it, right? You know...
to eat meat. So let me leave you with the evidence. Thank you for watching this video.
And fuck you.
Beautiful day, pair of pheasants. You can tell they want eating. They're almost screaming out, eat me, you bastard. Go on, eat me. Eat me, you bastard.
That's funny.
Yeah. Now, if you're still in any doubt whatsoever that the veggies have got it wrong, allow me to present you with piece of evidence number two. Yeah, now that is what I'm talking about.
Right, so you're just going to do, like, subjective stuff. So, like, if you fucked pigs, you would show a pig's anus and say... That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, all you pig fuckers like me understand exactly what I'm talking about, because we're all pig fuckers. So if the majority of human males enjoyed fucking pigs, this is a video that would have some relevance, right? Look at the pig fuckery, the pig anus. I mean, that is nauseating to me. It's disgusting, that piece of fat, disgusting shit. I mean, there's no way. I wouldn't even want to shit something that disgusting. Let alone put it in my mouth. So yeah, bravo. We, the majority of food perverts, that's all you're saying. We, the majority of food preference perverts, and that's what you are, you're perverted from any kind of natural simian diet, are going to just sit there and wallow in our majoritarianism and just celebrate our pig ass fuckery. Yeah, that's really philosophical and intelligent. I might as well talk to my sneakers than these idiots. I mean, really. what's the fucking point? I mean, this is the human fucking race. This is the best they can do. Look, don't you like it too? Huh, don't you? Huh? You're one of us, aren't you? One of the Borg? DNA Borg? Anyway. So, till next time. This goes on and on and on. The battle, the fight, the war.